Hey everybody, Fabody7 here, and welcome back to the channel with your favorite video of the week. Sorry, I didn't post anything last week, but I explained my reasons and everything is better now. So I got more time to do these video for you guys. So good thing it was just 1 week. First of all, let's go. Marquee matchup predictions. Feyenoord versus PSV. I know, my last video I got Feyenoord versus I don't know who. PSV, probably Ajax. But I'm going this one again. But I feel like EA has been diversifying this one. It's not as much Eredivisie, so maybe they'll go with the Turkish League. There's a very good match there. I'm forgetting the name, but I saw that there's a good match. So yeah, just invest in Dutch Eredivisie players. But again, they might go somewhere else. And even if it's right, the prices won't rise that much, to be honest. Then, second. Pros and cons. Pro Spanish League was not in marquee matchup last week, and also these are the two biggest teams facing each other. I'm not saying it's the biggest match, okay, but I'm trying to say it's in name they are the biggest facing each other, but of course there could be other classical derbies in there, like there was when Sevilla versus Betis, for example. It's not the biggest match in the world, but it is a classic, let's say, like that. The only problem with this one, they are so far apart. Barcelona is in first place, if I'm not mistaken, or at least the same points with Real Madrid. But now they are on the top, and Sevilla is actually closer to the bottom than to the top, which is sad, because, you know, Sevilla is that team, it's that team. But yeah, this one I think is going to be the second weakest, so I don't think there's going to be players from either club, so I would go with Spanish players and La Liga players with good nationalities and good positions. Then the third one, where I start putting some put to invest. Yeah, something happened with editing that Gabia card. They are going for 500. I don't know why. Maybe there's videos, maybe there's leaks, but the prices of these cards are a bit too expensive. Maybe it's because of the theme of the year grind. Could be that as well. Like I mentioned before, not playing FIFA, banned from the market, so I don't know the reality of the game itself. I do know the reality of the market, but not the game itself. I'm not following SBCs that much, to be honest, because not that type of content. Yeah, I took that Inter versus Milan, and I know it's different, but it gave me some minutes trying to find a new Milan image, so I went like that. Why is this match important? Inter and Milan, first of all, they use the same stadium, which is something very uncommon. They are separated by 2 points, so Inter is in second place and Milan is in fourth place, and there's Atalanta in the middle, but there's 2 points difference. So this is a match for the second place of Serie A. Both can lose a lot, because if they draw the game and Atalanta wins, Atalanta will be in second place. If Milan wins, Atalanta could go to second place if they also win. It's one of those games that I love, because I know this is important. This game is really important. There's a lot of factors in. I would heavily invest. I will, like I said, players are going, the silver ones going for about 500. I would try to get them for 400, 350 if you can. Maybe during the night in Europe, you can get it for 300 or less. So you can try that one, and then just sell on the hype, or if you want to risk it, sell when it's out. But I think the hype is the best one, because when it comes to requirements, I think I'll just ask one player from either team. And again, I don't see any cons. That's basically what I'm saying. I don't see any cons on this. I think it's 100%. And I think that's my opinion. The last one, Tottenham versus Manchester City. It's a top five game. It is the biggest, well, it's a top, like I said, top five game match, and it's the biggest one in I know Spurs is a bit historic, but not so many trophies, and City has a lot of trophies, but it has a more recent history. There's a lot of factors behind, but I think it might be in, because it's top five game. That's the way I'm gonna go. They can put Chelsea versus Fulham, okay, just to trick investors, which can happen. This is a prediction, not a guarantee, you know. Robertson and Bowden. I'll be honest with you guys, the last time I predicted these two guys, I made a shit ton of money. There's no other way to say it. The shit ton of money that was made. They are going for 200 coins at the moment. And like 2 weeks ago with the Liverpool guy, which I forget the name now, they can go to 1.2 easy. So you'll quintuple your profit, and they might ask either two players from either team or one player of each. So if you go Tottenham or City, you will make money definitely, because they will be very necessary. In this case, because there is a risk of Chelsea, I would just say go and sell on the hype. I think that would be a very, very good thing to do. Yeah, happy investing, guys. Please leave a like, a comment, hit the bell icon. You know, all those good things make us grow. And this is the only video that I literally ask you to share, okay? Only one I ask you to share. Sub button up here, latest video over there, which is old, actually. And Platinator's channel, where I've been posting things, finally. Guys, I'll see you on the next one. Either Team of the Week predictions, or maybe if I'm right with the marquee matchups, it's going to be marquee matchups profits explained. So remember, everything up here and follow, you know. Bye.